Lehendakaria, herri agintariok eta lagunok, eskerrik asko etortzagatik eta egunon. And thank you very much to all of you who have come from abroad and be very welcome to the Basque country and to knowing us and our Basque industry strategy. Laugarren urtez elkartu gara 4.0 industriaren inguruko topaketa egun handi honetan. Gero eta handiago, gero eta jarraitzaile eta parte hartzaile gehiago ditugu. Gero eta ezagutza handiago dugu estrategia honetan. Baina 2014 urtean aditzera eman genizuen estrategia hau ez da gurea, guztiona da. Martxan jarri genuen, baina ez da nahikoa estrategia izatea, baizik eta garatzea, eta horretan ari gera. Horretan ari gera eta gaurko jardunaldian ere ez bakarrikan nondik norakoa dan gure estrategia eta zertan ari geran, baizik eta zuek zertan ari zeraten, nola ezartzen ari zeraten eta ze adibide dituzuen, ze ekimen dituzuen ezagutu nahi ditugu. Ekitaldiaren hasieran urtero izaten dugu aukera ikusteko estrategia hau nola garatzen dugun, lehendakaria berak aipatzen zuen bezala pilotaje taldea zertan ari dan, nola ari dan lanean, eta gaur ere esan behar dizuet zertan aritu geran, eta aipatu behar dizuet emankorra izan dela urte hau. Bereziki emankorra izan da 2017 urte hau. Como todos los años, asumo ese compromiso de comentar, permítanme la expresión, minuto y resultado de cómo se encuentra la estrategia y su implantación, sobre todo, en qué ha trabajado el grupo de pilotaje este año, y decía en euskera que nos ha traído novedades, hemos trabajado mucho, han trabajado mucho con todas las empresas del país, y desde luego creo que se empiezan a ver los resultados. Y con el deseo de ser lo más directa posible, y de continuar con los retos que nos mencionaban, to carry on working on those challenges that the President mentioned a few minutes ago. I'm going to try to talk about the three challenges and where we are. The first that the Lendakari mentioned was to avoid any companies being left behind. That's what's actually the most relevant point of our strategy, to make sure that all Basque companies go at the same speed. We don't want a two-speed industry. Industry Basque 4.0. We don't want some people being left behind and then running the risk of these companies of maybe having to close because of their lack of technology and not being updated. The Basque government and especially the steering group, which has technological groups, university centers and FP, VET centers collaborating in them, the first thing that they've done is set up the Basque Digital Innovation Hub, which is a networked platform, and is going to work on different R&D infrastructures to provide all industrial companies with the possibility of having those technological new things within their reach, especially those SMEs that don't have the possibility of accessing this technology rapidly. They're going to have it at their fingertips to be able to face up to the challenges of Industry 4.0. We know that not all companies can have all the technology. That's why there's this aim of having a digital hub, i.e. a platform that can help all our SMEs. I'm not going to talk more about this initiative because the executive manager of it will tell us about it this afternoon. So I've just given you a brief outline. And the second challenge, the Basque Cybersecurity Center. There's increasing digitization in what we do in industry. That's good because it's going to improve our competitiveness. But just like all good initiatives, there are risks attached to it. And to face these risks, the Basque country has got its cybersecurity center, which has been up and running since September, and is going to offer this infrastructure to all Basque industries. It's going to be in permanent contact with all of you to find out about your situation, to help you with your problems, and to try to improve day by day. In cybersecurity, actually, security, complete 100% security doesn't exist, but what we need to do is to work so that it gets increasingly better. This is another initiative that will be presented this afternoon by the director, Javier Dieguez, and there are two cases that he's going to be talking about. But in addition to this, I wanted to highlight something that's related tecnología, que este presupuesto de 2018 recoge un incremento de alrededor del 6% para todo lo que es la I+D, la tecnología y la digitalización de la empresa vasca. Van a ser prácticamente 192 millones de euros dedicados a todos estos aspectos. Horrela, inorratzen duzik gabe jarraitu nahi dugu aurrera, eta horretarako bideratu ditugu bi iniziatiba garrantzitsu horiek, Basque Digital Innovation Hub eta Zibersegurtasun Zentroa, eta noski beti garrantzitsua izaten da iniziatiba daudenean baita ere zati ekonomikoa gehitzea, eta horre ere esfortzu handi egin dugu Jaurlaritza bezala. Baina beti esaten dizuet, gurea zati bat da, zuena da garrantzitsua, gurea laguntzailea da, zureak, zuenak behar dute benetan teknologia horiek ezartzeko behar ditugun aktibitate ekonomikoak. El segundo de los retos es la formación, la capacitación en materia de todas estas tecnologías en el 4.0, pero no solo las tecnologías, requerimos también formación, trabajo en equipo, transparencia, es decir, formas de actuar también diferentes. Beraz, bigarren erronka hau formakuntzari jarri diogu bideratuta, langileen gaitasuna lortu nahi dugu, teknologia berrietan, baina aipatzen duen gazteleraz ez bakarrikan teknologian, baizik eta lankidetzan, transparentzian, gardentasunez lan egiten, modu berrietan lan egiten, eta guzti hori noski hezkuntza sailarekin lantzen ari gera. Eta bertan pilotaje taldean beraiek ere zati garrantzitsu bat dute, ardatz garrantzitsu bat dute. Hasiera-hasieratik, gaztetxoen galtikan hasi eta unibertsitateraino iritsiz. Beti ere euskal beharrei, euskal enpresen beharrei erantzun ahal izateko. Tenemos que generar talento, disponer de profesionales cualificados, pero también cualificar, adaptar, flexibilizar los que ya se encuentran trabajando en todas las empresas de Euskadi, ser atractivos también para poder traer ese talento que se encuentra en el extranjero y que nos va a hacer falta en nuestra demografía, nos va a obligar a tener ese talento bien preparado en nuestra empresa, bien preparada va a ser capaz de atraerlo también. Entre las acciones que destacan, además de las que realiza el Departamento de Educación, in the Education Department, which I'm sure the Deputy Minister for Vocational Training, Jorge Arevalo, will be talking about afterwards. And by the way, I'd like to congratulate him for the recognition that VET in the Basque Country has been recognized in the European Union. So congratulations, Jorge, for that. As the President was saying, in SPRI, we offer more than 300 training courses on digitization and new technology, to train every year over 10,000 students from around the Basque Country. In the tripartite committee, we've also reached an agreement in which employers, trade unions and the government analyze the impact of Industry 4.0 on employment so as to adapt the training to what is needed. We are committed to analyze the job of the future and the profiles of the workers for the future, and we're going to be doing that as quickly as possible. And our aim for 2018 is to drive forward what we call industrial PhDs, that is to face the needs of industry of the future with PhD holders, because these are going to be the people that are going to bring this technology to these companies. And we'll be spending over 6 million euros on that over the next years. And the third challenge, which included positioning the Basque Country internationally within Industry 4.0, perhaps here I ought to highlight that it's necessary
solo vamos a destacar si ponemos en funcionamiento algo nuevo,
the fact that we're only going to be successful if we do something new, something innovative, a product or a service that somebody's prepared to pay for and to pay well for, because if we want to be a productive industry, if we want our economy to carry on being based on the manufacturing industry, we need to be competitiveness. We need to be competitive, otherwise we're going to miss our opportunity and not have our position on the map. So
in the second call for Bind 4.0, the startup accelerator in the 4.0 field, that's what we're doing to help that. Last year, around a dozen large industrial companies took part in this program. This year, we've virtually doubled that, and we've received 385 projects that want to take part as a startup. In this project, that's 50% more than the previous year. Of these, 232 are international in nature. Today, we'll be able to find out more about the 50 startups that have already been chosen, and so that industrial companies in the Basque Country can find out more about them to see whether they need their services and, of course, access directly the skills that they offer. Now, the other challenge, the challenge of positioning the Basque Country. We've done several things to that end. For the first time last year, we went to the Hanover Messe Trade Fair. Basque Industry 4.0 had special relevance in that trade fair, and we'll be going back for 2018. Once more, we were able to present our strategy at Brussels, London, Canada, and in Colombia, and in the Bavaria Digitalization Center, one of the most relevant in Germany.
Ekimen hauek estrategiaren inguruan ari gerala eta ondo ari gerala esan nahi dute, baina ezin dugu atzera gelditu, pentsatuz ze ondo joan zaigun 2017an, jarraitu egin behar dugu, intensitatez, sakontasunez eta elkarrekin lan eginez. Guztiak, ekimen guztiak izango dira uztargarriak, zuen beharrak eta benetan kanpotikan datozen beharrak, eta horrei erantzuteko gaur izango dugu parada. Hausnarketak izango dira, zuek egin duzuena jakiteko, eta animatzen zaituztet, ekimen hauekin jarraitzen, ze benetan Euskadik asko jokatzen du arlo honetan. Hau ez da zerbait urtero esaten dut, eta horrekin bukatu nahi dut. Ez da zerbait hautatzeko dana, baizik eta egin behar dugun zerbait. Guztion artean egin behar dugu, baino ez dago atzera bueltatzeko paradarik, ez dago atzera begiratzeko momenturik, eta aurrera egiteko honetan animatzen zaituztet jarraitzea. Eskerrik asko zuen implikazioatik, eta espero dut gaurko jardunaldia egokia izango dela zuentzako, eta beteko dituela ekarri dituzuen helburu guztiak. Mila-mila esker.